guess he kind of looks embarrassed. A little bit. Sad Otter first appeared on the internet in 2012, but since then he's popped up all over the place, even recently appearing in an article in the New York Times. I'm not really sure why Sad Otter went viral. It was probably something about his expression that people found so compelling. I have looked at a lot of images of the actual species, so the giant river otter, and they do have very downturned mouths naturally, so I don't know that it's too far off. Well, the specimen was collected by the museum in 1884. So people came to museums and were able to get up close and see these amazing creatures from all over the world. And often they were displayed in habitat dioramas as well, so they were able to see these animals in their environments. And it was a bit like, you know, kind of an early form of like a nature documentary. This was long before we ever got Sir David Attenborough. It wasn't even refrigeration when the Sad Otter was taxidermied. So someone put a lot of work into making sure that it stayed in good condition. You know, there are some cases of taxidermy where you end up with some really strange anatomical irregularities where, you know, legs are kind of going off into a strange direction. Maybe it's a little bit like a story told by an unreliable narrator. You know, when you see a bad piece of taxidermy, you're in on the joke because you know what that animal is supposed to look like and you know how far short the taxidermist came. But, you know, none of this is happening here. But also from a natural sciences point of view, giant otters are endangered in the wild now, and that means that it's still really useful even if it doesn't necessarily look exactly like the animal it came from. Sad Otter really doesn't have that many reasons to be sad. You know, he's an object that brings a lot of joy and wonder to a lot of people. He's also a really important scientific specimen, so he's contributing to a lot of great research that the museum is doing, you know, with our own scientists and scientists all over the world.